What, are we gonna get all Negan in this episode? Oh, you mean that kind of battery. Also, this is the worst cosplay I've ever done. Hey guys, I'm Trisha Hirschberger, and don't worry, I put the bat away. In this episode of DIY in 5, we'll teach you the basics of what to look out for when buying a portable battery bank. Don't forget to subscribe and check out our other tips and tricks to keep your mobile buddies working better. Power banks now come in all sorts of sizes, from the little chapstick size units you get for free at trade shows to units that are the size of car batteries. But it's not quite so easy to understand as the days of AA, C, or whatever your toy needed. Batteries today show ratings in milliamp hours, or mAh for short. You'll see numbers that range from 2,000 to 20,000 or even higher. But what does that actually mean for you? Most smartphones today have batteries that are in the 2 to 3,000 milliamp hour range. So with a 2,000 milliamp power bank, you can get about half a charge for your phone. You may be thinking, wait a second, Trish, the math does not add up. There's always a little bit of battery drain when using the power bank. So even if your phone battery matches the size of your power bank, you probably won't get a 100% charge. If you get one of those beefy 20,000 milliamp hour units, you can expect to charge your new iPhone, Galaxy, or whatever you have about 8 times. Love it. But battery size is only one piece of the puzzle. Usually what I want to know is how quickly I can get back to a full charge. If you're looking for batteries, you'll see terms like fast charge, quick charge, or something similar. What do those actually mean? Quick charge is an actual technology used on some Android phones, but you have to have an Android with a Qualcomm processor to take advantage. It allows you to safely charge your device as fast as possible. They claim it works up to 4 times faster than other standard chargers. So what about the rest of us who aren't lucky enough to have a Qualcomm phone? Well, that's where fast charging, or whatever similar term the battery bank you're looking at is using. It's essentially just charging your phone using 2 amps instead of the 1/2 amp charger that most phones come with. There's some debate on whether or not this type of fast charge can ruin batteries quicker, but in a pinch, it sure is handy. Then, of course, there's color, shape, style. That's all personal preference. Anybody in the market for a new power bank? Let us know what you're looking for in the comments below. And if you want to learn specifically how to make your iPhone battery last longer, then check out this video here. Thanks for watching DIY in 5, and oh yeah, pro tip for convention goers. Bring as many portable batteries as you can carry. The crappy signal battery drain plus long days without being near an outlet are killer. How else are you gonna tweet out that sweet pic you took with Dumbledore?